Hi there, welcome to another video. Today I am thinking of replacing the power button on this iPod Nano 6 Gen. It's been lying around for a while, and when you press it, nothing happens, and it doesn't turn on. I know it's got charge in it because whenever you put the cable in, it shows up display and it says it's charged, and that's the only way to turn it on. Otherwise, you take the cable out and nothing happens. So anyway, let's get down to it. We need to heat the frame first. I've bought the cable that needs to be replaced, so hopefully that should do the trick. And let's see what we can do. We're going to use the suction cup to pull the screen off. Hopefully that will work, and then we might use one of these to just take the adhesive off on the sides. But we need to heat this thing up. As with any Apple product, there are no screws to open something properly, so use a hairdryer, or we can use a hot air gun. So hopefully this is like it's quite hot now, so let's see if it can release it. Yep, it's gonna come off now. I haven't opened one of these before, so that's going to be interesting to see if I can do any success with this. There we go. So let's take this off. I think we have had already success with removing this. Let me put my glasses. glasses on. So that's pretty much what it looks like from underneath. There we are. Blimey. It's quite sophisticated, isn't it? Right, let's get down to the power button, which is effectively underneath this tray. So we've got to take this tray out first. Let's see if we can screwdriver. To use something like this, maybe. That's one. And there's another one in this corner. Cover comes off. Now inside here we need to now be very careful what we remove. This is the display. This is the display connector. Let's remove that gently. And it comes off. Well, that's quite a few of those actually. That's the battery one. So let's get rid of that first. And then the display one. Should be able to just take that off. There we go. So the display has now come off. So let's disconnect and put the display on the other side and focus on the button that doesn't work, which is this one here. So let's see, we can then, we may need to remove the battery as well, but I guess pretty much everything has to come out in this little area. Here is the actual screwdriver. Let's see if we can lift this battery out, or does it need to be? Because the button is actually behind the battery. Batteries coming out. There he is. Be very careful with the battery actually, because I thought there was a connector for it, but there isn't one. Still putting. This comes off. Okay, looks like the switch and everything is actually behind this tape. Very well made. Don't think it was designed to be opened again, like a lot of Apple products. that would be there. Okay. Peel this tape off. All it is tape, luckily, and it didn't actually put any adhesive in there. So yeah, the button is right at the back in there. That's, if you see, oops, if you see here, that's inside there, that's where the button is underneath here. There, that's where the button is in there. So all of that needs to come out. Interesting, because it's amazing how much work has been done just by sticking things in the underneath here. Now the challenging part is to how to open this piece underneath here. My, oh my. Do I need a screwdriver? Screws there, my mistake. Ah, screw is underneath here. There it is. Let's peel all of this off. These two screws should release the power button. Right, so then that should come off, right? Ah, there it is. That seems to be working right. What seems to be the problem there? Back in, if it works. replacing the whole circuit. I wonder how does this actually... Oh, right, yep, so that's broken. So you have to replace the entire... Here we are. Right, so what has happened here is that the flexi cable here, that is here, there, that's broken off. I think it's kind of went really, really weak. And then it connects to the circuit underneath there as well, so... That's the entire nano here. Leave that here for now. Now work on this cable here and installing everything back again. It's going to be interesting. Continue in a minute. Hi there. So I'm back again. Just had to take a quick break. Most of the parts are all screwed in. It's like one cable that feeds into all of this. So I have to take everything out just to replace the power button. Let's see if we can do this. There comes out the volume buttons, I think. Yep, there they are. Let's remove the volume buttons from this. It's like a little gasket seal so water doesn't go in, but it does anyway. Right, it comes out. Power button stays in. Surprisingly, the power button is already in there, but... pull out as well. Power button actually doesn't have any movement at all, which is quite surprising. Looks like it must have had some water ingress in it. Remember how these all went in, but at the moment, it's going to need the power button starts to work now. It's a bit of a contact cleaner. Yeah, that wasn't moving before. Yeah. It's all fine now. So you need to remember how everything is put together. And easy. Now the challenging part is to put the new one back in. See if we can do that. Here is our double-sided sticky tape. Let's open it. Hey, good news. Cody comes with pre-stuck stickers, so that's good. So I don't need to worry about it. Okay, so you can see this has already got a black tape wrapped around the connectors for some reason. Why there's tape on it? Guess it doesn't bother me. Let the tape be. Perfect. It all looks good. Right, that's going to go like that. Right, so let's put the screw back in. Take one of them. We can take this off, press this down a bit. Turn this around so we can then go back in. Peel off these. I have to use two tweezers. This is the power button. Off the existing switch, which is very, very delicate. This is I think this is quite well secured. Maybe it will need a little bit of poking out. There we go. That's all come out. It's quite a good seal on that. Right, let's pick this up. This back in there. Say it's very delicate and sophisticated work, but sure, you get that at the end. There we go. That looks pretty on to me. Brilliant. If we fold this now and bring it on top of that, like the one before. So like that. There we go, so that's in. Now the challenging part is to put it back in its place. Let's see how it actually works. Right, here we go. Push this in. I think it's because it's a new... Yep, I can feel it already. That's a good sign, but that's not all, because we need to get this rubber back into it. On it as well. Which... I believe was on there. Just to prevent from any water or anything else going in. So let's see if we can do that. Let's put this back. Yep, that's all working. Right, Lisa's making the noise that it never did before. Right, which one? Plus and minus. Well, I guess it can only go one way. It is this way. Yep. And then we have the same situation on this, which is the that one there. And here we need to pull off the other piece. It's meant to be peeled off once it's on, so it has to... That's one off. Oops. It's more like the board is coming off. There we go. Come off. Brilliant. Now what we need to do, clean it up a bit. I guess we do want to keep a bit of sticky stuff on there, so the other one will stick on properly. It's fine. Peel. Like little surgery, this is good. So we want to make sure that we get it the right way around, which is this way. And then we need to peel this off. Then we need to put this on the other side. Right there. Mm-hmm. Here we go. That's it. Press it down. That's all in. And all we need to now do is to make sure we fold this back. That way, so we've got that as well. Put this back in there. Yep, there it goes in there. And now we need to put that gasket on. Make sure there's no water ingress. Now we take it down. And corner with the help of tweezers, of course, push it in its place. There it is. Now we just use one of the screws to make sure it doesn't fall out. Sorry, my hand's in the way, but you know. Interesting. No, the extra piece goes in. It's just, we'll find out when you put it in, but let's hold in. Let's see if it works. I can feel it, the clicking is coming now, so yep. And that's all in. Right, now let's see. Okay, so we had. Let's put in, and then I think there's a fold on this piece here in there, under the little place here. Fold can go in like that, and there it is. And you just need to fold it in. I think that's the reason why it's there. Right, let's make sure that fold stays folded. That's probably why there was tape on there, so it doesn't come out. And let's put this some kind of tape back where it was. That's kind of gone in where it's meant to. Yeah, hi, welcome back. Sorry, your memory card just ran out of space. Typical, isn't it? So, the screen is now on, so if we just put this cable in, here we are. Oh, yep, it's playing. Yep, and that's, yep, pretty much that's all going, and the power button, yep, press it, and it goes. Volume up, down, yep, that's all working. So let's take this out. And as I said, the battery is there, so let me just turn it off. I wonder if I hold it down, it shut down. Yep, it's shutting down now, it's gone. So let's just pop this back in its place. What we need now is a bit of glue around. before I pop it in. So let's do that. You can see we've had a bit of I'll scrape that off, otherwise it's just this here as well. Right, I think one side actually slides in, so which is quite nice. And the glue actually holds on to these three areas. So I just take this piece off as well. And that should come off. It's more like double-sided sticky tape of some sort, this is. Anyway, let's use the... Oh, this is the clear one. I've got the black one as well. It's the B7000 and the BT7000. They all seem to be doing the same thing. Right. So if I just pop this around this area. There. And basically it's a bit like rubber glue, this is. There. A bit there. And a bit there, a bit there, a bit there. I think maybe some of the edges automatically grip onto it a bit there. Enough to secure the thing, the screen in its place. It's not like I'm taking it underwater, is it? Just a simple home DIY. Just press this back in its place. There we go. Closes nice and easy. Press it down. Wipe all the corners off. Okay. Hopefully. And that's it. But then have it. Now if we just try to make sure that there isn't anything sticking out on this, on the side, just clean them up. And this gives them a nice clean edge. There we go. Let me just turn the light off so we can see. There we are. Right, looks like that's all fixed now. So, time to play it. Let's see if it plays. Right, okay. Let me put the cable in and we'll continue a bit. Right, let's power it on and see if it now plays. It should play now. Let's increase the volume a bit. Yep, that's all playing now. It's got music, playlists, and let's see. I've got quite a few songs here. That's quite nice, but it also has a... There you go. There you go, it's playing now. Great. So that's all working. I can turn it off. So that's it turns the display off, basically. So yeah, that's all playing now. So yeah. Well, I think that was a successful fix after using the supplied cable that I bought. And basically we just replaced the entire cable assembly to the new one. Just have to wait for it to dry now, and hopefully it's all good to go. Thanks for watching. Until next time, bye for now.